Well, it's been a long time. Let's see, last video upload was April 2nd. If you're joining us for the first time, we're a sister team, and we create biology videos using cartoons. Our videos are illustrated by my sister Petunia and narrated and taught by myself, Pinky, a former high school biology teacher. We have a pretty good excuse for our four-month absence. Petunia had a baby, baby Rose. Her due date was actually in mid-June, but Petunia developed preeclampsia just like I had in the past. Baby Rose arrived 2 months early, but both of them are doing well. We're excited to be back. We're going to try to make our videos once a month again. But right now, with the pandemic, we're not sure how everything will look. In order for Petunia to draw, she will need to make sure to find care for baby Rose during the times that she's illustrating. And I will need the same for my youngest in order to write scripts and record. You will notice that we will be a little slower with other projects as we prioritize our videos. But we'll still create new science comics and GIFs. You can find them on our website. Petunia hopes to start her webtoon back up soon. We know the school year may look a little different this year. Petunia wanted to talk a little about that now. Petunia, take it away.
Thank you, Pinky. Hey, everyone. I wanted to thank you all for your kind words and encouragement while I've been recovering. My life was flipped upside down really quickly back in April, and not just because of the pandemic. I told my sister that I really wanted to do a pep talk video as everyone heads back to a very uncertain school year. But what are the right words to say? That things could always be worse? That we should be grateful for what we do have? I don't want my words to be empty. I guess in the end, a pep talk isn't really something I can give. But I do have one thing I've learned from having a baby during the pandemic, and that is you're allowed to grieve for the things that you didn't get to experience this year. I grieve the experiences I was never able to have in my last trimester, like baby showers and the presence of family at Rose's birth. People will tell you to look on the bright side and be grateful for your health. And yes, they are right. But you can still grieve. Maybe you lost a school trip, prom, championships, graduation, an academic competition, or a school play. Grieve it. Have a good cry. Even if it feels trivial, it's sad you didn't get to have that, and I am sorry. 2020 is proving to be a tough year. We have to learn how to hold it together during hard times, and that's by acknowledging that you lost something and giving yourself permission to grieve that. This experience is so different for all of us, and I know some days it is hard to be positive. It's okay. You're going to be messy some days. Just do your best. And if there are days that you can't do your best, cut yourself some slack and try again the next day. Most importantly, remember that those around you are also restless and tired and are likely going through their own personal challenges. Try to cut them some slack too. So whether you're going back to school virtually or in person with a mask, or maybe you're not sure what your school is doing yet, be gentle with yourself and others. As for us, we'll be here working hard to make your biology course as interesting as possible. Well, that's it for the Amoeba Sisters, and we remind you to stay curious.